Hey guys, it's another week, another episode of Ages of Sheila's Earth, so we've got another theory video to discuss all the theories that we've got on the rest of this season, and in addition to that I'm going to make a couple of clarifications over the course of this video, and also talk a little bit about a theory that I've got about Season 7. I know, you think I'm crazy, why the hell are you theorizing about Season 7 before Season 6 is over? The truth is, there's a little bit that we know about Season 7, and a little bit of an arc that we know about on Season 6 that does seem that it completely fits with that piece of information that we know about Season 7. So let us first get done with that, then move on to the clarifications, and then move on to the Season 6 related theories. Alright, so here are the facts. So it has been reported that on Season 7 we're going to be seeing FDR, as in Franklin D. Roosevelt. Now if that were to be true, that would mean that Season 7 is going to be set in the past. That means that time travel is going to be involved. That would also mean that the promised cliffhanger at the end of this season, that's going to be all about time travel. And that could possibly mean multiple things, the first of which is that the Chronicoms, you know, Ultara and Malachi and whatnot, they are going to succeed in going back to the past in order to change the future of Chronica 2. And we did see Malachi and Balgad at the very end of Episode 8 in the stinger of the episode, and Malachi was pretty much about to head into the brains of Fitz and Simmons, the records that they got out of putting them into that machine. So what he's about to do over here is uncover how to go for time travel, how to go back to the past, and they're probably gonna end up achieving it. That's gonna be the final battle of the season, or the final moments of the season, before he heads into the past, and then the team follows. So yeah, I think that's the cliffhanger that the producers promised during WonderCon back in April. You know, there's gonna be a cliffhanger because we know we've got a Season 7, and that considered, it is easy to plan for such a thing ahead of time. But that's the part about my thoughts on Season 7, the arc that's gonna continue into Season 7, that being the Chronicom arc trying to save Chronica 2. So let us move on to one of the two clarifications that I mentioned earlier. Now I've gotten a lot of comments on my review video of the most recent episode. Over this part, a lot of people have been commenting on the conversation between Mac and Daisy close to the end of the episode, you know, during the reunion party. There's been a mention of a debrief, there's been a mention of 5 years, like where have you been for the past 5 years, and a lot of people assumed, okay, what are they doing? I mean, it was a 1 year time jump, now it seems like they're doing a retcon, like they've jumped 5 years into the future, and they're trying to address Endgame, like slowly but steadily getting there. But the truth is though, the statement is kinda different. I didn't think I could come back to anything more bizarre, but I should have known better, that's what Daisy says. The response that she gets from Mac was, well, where you been the last 5 years? I'm looking forward to that debrief. Now the debrief over here is a reference to his question earlier, when do I get to hear stories about deep space, and to her response accordingly when we sit down for debrief. So that was really all about the 1 year that they spent in space. His statement about the 5 years, that's all about context, and the context over here, where the hell have you been for the past 5 years? Yeah, you should have expected that, something more bizarre than what you saw out there once you come back to Earth. The 5 years, if you think about it, are the 5 years that Mac has known Daisy, he's known her since Season 2, that's Season 2, 3, 4, 5, and the 1 year that she spent in space, where have you been for the past 5 years? He's made his first appearance on Season 2, he's met Daisy on Season 2, so these are the 5 years that he could speak about when it comes to knowing Daisy, knowing what she's been through. But the second clarification though, or rather a theory, is all about Davis. A lot of people have been wondering what was going on with Davis, is something wrong with him? Some fans do believe that he was possessed by Azel, like she jumped bodies into his body in order to escape the Lazy Comet before it got all blown up. And some others do believe that he's been infected with Shrikes. Now, the thing about the Shrikes option, you know, once they infect you and get to you, you're not really able to talk. That's what we know so far from watching so many people who have been infected with the Shrikes. So the answer over there is probably no, because that's what we know from Sarge as well. I mean, when he met Deke, he was like, you're too much of a talker. Back then, he thought he was infected. And it was kind of weird for him. I mean, you know, these people infected with the Shrikes, they're not talkers at all. We did notice that on the Lazy Comet as well. So there's really no reason to believe that this guy was infected with a Shrike, none whatsoever. The other two options though is that he was possessed by Azel. I do believe he was possessed by Azel. His statement to Piper at the very end of the episode, that did make him sound like the person who escaped a near-death event, that was not really him. That was all about Azel talking, you know, I escaped the Lazy Comet, I made it out of there by hopping bodies into this guy's body. But even though I'm pretty much under this impression, I do think there is the possibility that the producers, the writers of this episode, did want us to think so. Like that wasn't really the case. There's going to be a major surprise later on. You could be under one impression, but you can't claim that you're 100% sure when you don't know for sure, when you haven't written the episode, when you don't know what's going in the minds of the producers and the writers of the series. But moving on though, one thing that was very much highlighted close to the end of the episode was the Daisy letter. That's pretty much the letter that Coulson told her about at the end of season 5. You know, I left you something in your bunk, check it out. It's nothing fancy, I'm just telling you how proud I am of you. Now I've got multiple possibilities on my mind over here, the first of which is this letter was highlighted, as in, you know, this is the last thing that she's got from Coulson, of Coulson. And it is kind of a reminder of how much she cared for Coulson, how much Coulson still means to her. But there's also the other option, you know, she never read it. The letter is not just about being proud of her, but about telling her more, like possibly more, about his Ghost Rider deal. Now, I've always assumed it was one thing for the other with the Ghost Rider. It's still a possibility. The whole Ghost Rider thing could have been sealed by the end of season 5, but there's always the chance that they're expanding on it. Like, there were other conditions to that contract, to that deal, that we don't know about. And remember, Coulson did not really tell them that he was dying until he had to, and he possibly didn't tell them the full truth. Why would he need to cause these people, to cause Daisy, to cause Meg, to cause everyone that loved him unnecessary pain, unless he really had to? But that also takes us to another theory. Who is Sarge? Is he Coulson? Is he not Coulson? I'm thinking at this point, he is in the body of Coulson. But he might not be really Coulson, like the soul, the spirit, the person, whatever you want to call it, he might not be really Coulson. But the thing is, I do think there's a mix in there, like there are residuals of Coulson, and then there's this other person, Sarge. Now the reason I say this is a mix of things. This is the skin he's wearing, that's what Azel made clear on the most recent episode. That means it's not the first time, that means it's not the first skin that he's wearing, that he did wear other people's skin before he got into Coulson's body. There is also the fact that the name, the word Coulson, it did ring a bell. Now that makes me think of the residual of Coulson in that body, like the residual of the soul, the spirit, the mind of Coulson, like they're both mashed up. If the guy did his research, Sarge that is, like you know, which body am I getting, he would have been like, yeah, Coulson, that's the name of the guy who used to occupy this body, or he used to own this body, but he didn't say that, he was like, I don't know, but it rings a bell. So yeah, there are residuals in there. That might be one thing that the series is doing over here in order to bring back Coulson. But that still poses the question, who is Sarge? Now the first thing we need to remember about Sarge over here is that he does know Azel. He's probably known her for too long, at least that's what seems to be the case at the moment. And if he did, and if we take Azel's words at face value, there were no memories to start with. You know, there was no woman that you loved, there was no family that you lost. That means that his animosity with Azel has started for other reasons, like maybe they were in league, one of them decided to go a different way, down a different path, like Azel for example. She went all evil, she decided to go down a path of darkness and destruction, and that's when Sarge kinda changed his mind. So she wiped his memories of her, and that's when they became enemies, because no matter what she did, the one part that she could not erase, the one part that remained part of his read-only memory, that's the part about him hating her, him going after her. But this though is just one possibility there, because there are so many possibilities. Once you start assuming that they've known each other for too long, there are so many possibilities, one of which is Sarge is a demonic entity, or has been implanted in this body by a demonic entity, and the objective over here would be to hunt down Azel. I still think that this theory is more plausible. I still think that the chances are this season is both about Incan mythology and a little bit of the Ghost Rider deal, or at least a demonic entity at play. But for the time being though, let's keep an open mind. We've been given a lot this season, and a lot of it points in different directions. A lot of options, a lot of possibilities out there. We've just gotta wait and find out which one will actually stick. That being said, my work here is done, so let me know in the comments down below what you thought of these theories. Let me know what you think of the season 7 theory. Do you think the Chronicom story is going to be addressed this season? Do you think it's going to be addressed on the upcoming season? And of course the weekly question, who do you think Sarge is? Do you think this body is Coulson's or not? Let me know as well if you did like this video by dropping it a much appreciated like, subscribing to this channel, Make sure while you're at it to enable notifications in order to get updates whenever I upload a new video, publish a new community post, or start a new live stream. But until the next time that you tune in for another one of my videos, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. or otherwise, thank you so much for tuning in to this theory video, and have a great day.